They want you to believe that our ancestors were ignorant. But what if I told you that 1500 years ago, supposedly primitive civilizations achieved feats that even today, modern engineers cannot explain? Get ready. You are about to discover Sigiriya, the structure that could change everything you think you know about the history of humankind. Imagine a colossal fortress built atop a 200-meter-high rock in the middle of the jungle, using technology so advanced that many modern engineers are still puzzled by it. This is not science fiction, it is reality. And the most astonishing part, the true purpose of Sigiriya may have gone far beyond what history books teach. Stay with me until the end, because what you are about to discover about the secret gardens, hidden mechanisms, and the incredible hydraulic engineering of Sigiriya will make you question everything you learned at school. Sigiriya, the Lion Fortress and the Echo of a Lost Era. Sigiriya, often called the Lion Rock, is much more than an archaeological marvel. It is a testament to the ambition, ingenuity, and political turbulence that shaped the history of ancient Sri Lanka. This grand narrative begins in the 5th century AD, immortalized in the pages of the Kulavamsa, the Sinhalese historical chronicle that documents the rise and fall of kings and dynasties. According to the account, Kasapa, the illegitimate son of King Datusena, defied the natural order by overthrowing his half-brother Moggallana, the legitimate heir. Through a bold and brutal coup, Kasapa seized the throne, fully aware that his newly acquired power was under constant threat. Fearing the revenge of Moggallana, who sought refuge and support in southern India, Kasapa decided to abandon the traditional capital of Anuradhapura and establish his center of power in a location that combined majesty with natural defense. The awe-inspiring Rock of Sigiriya, a granite column rising almost 200 meters above the plain. Atop this monolith, Kasapa ordered the construction of a fortified citadel and a splendid palace surrounded by meticulously planned gardens, moats, and walls. The design of Sigiriya was not merely a military fortification effort, but also an artistic and ideological statement of royal dominion, an attempt to create an earthly paradise that reflected his near-divine authority. Sigiriya, forgotten and rediscovered, a historical renaissance. After the tragic fall of Kasapa, who committed suicide on the battlefield in the face of Moggallana's army, returned from exile, Sigiriya lost its function as a royal residence and was eventually converted into a Buddhist monastery. Over time, however, the relentless Sinhalese jungle advanced, covering the structures and erasing its living memory. It was only in 1831 that the site re-emerged to the world, when Major Jonathan Forbes, while exploring the forests on horseback, stumbled upon the gigantic vegetation-covered rock. Intrigued, Forbes reported his observations, complemented by detailed sketches that quickly captured the interest of the British academic and colonial community. His discovery paved the way for Sigiriya to be recognized not merely as a curiosity, but as an archaeological heritage site of global significance. The first investigations, from empiricism to archaeological science. In the following years, the exploration of Sigiriya went through an initial phase of empirical and sometimes amateur investigations. It was an era when enthusiasm for antiquities outweighed methodological rigor. However, a new approach emerged in 1895 under the leadership of H.C.P. Bell, the first archaeological commissioner of Ceylon. Bell introduced more systematic techniques, promoting controlled excavations, detailed mapping of the ruins, and meticulous documentation of findings. Bell's work revealed that Sigiriya was not merely a fortified castle, but a sophisticated urban complex with symmetrical gardens, innovative hydraulic structures, and an urban layout that reflected a profound understanding of aesthetics and engineering. In the 20th century, the Sri Lankan Department of Archaeology continued this legacy, conducting scientific excavations that culminated in the designation of Sigiriya as a UNESCO World Heritage Site in 1982. This phase intensified efforts in preservation, restoration, and interpretation of the site. The frescoes of Sigiriya, immortality on the walls. Among Sigiriya's treasures, the extraordinary frescoes painted on the western face of the rock stand out. These murals, depicting divine female figures, possibly representations of apsaras, goddesses of the clouds, or even members of the royal court, are considered one of the finest artistic expressions of ancient Sri Lanka. Executed with natural mineral pigments on fine plaster, these frescoes have survived the erosion of the centuries, preserving vibrant colors and an impressive subtlety in expressions and movements. Although there are parallels with the techniques seen in the Ajanta caves in India, the paintings of Sigiriya reveal a unique aesthetic, characterized by an almost ethereal lightness, where the figures seem to float amid a dreamlike atmosphere. Modern studies suggest that the frescoes were part of a gallery that covered a vast area of the rock wall, a kind of panoramic mural of celestial beauty intended to impress and inspire visitors. The hydraulic gardens of Sigiriya, a masterpiece of ancient engineering. Another remarkable facet of Sigiriya is its complex garden system, considered one of the oldest and most sophisticated examples of landscape planning in the world. The water gardens, with their rectangular pools, fountains, and pavilions, demonstrate an advanced understanding of hydraulic engineering, employing underground channels, pressure valves, and water recirculation mechanisms. Some scholars compare Sigiriya's engineering to the mythical Hanging Gardens of Babylon, pointing out that technological achievements of such magnitude were not exclusive to Mesopotamian civilizations. More than merely ornamental, the gardens of Sigiriya represented the perfect fusion of art, nature, and science, designed to delight the senses and symbolize cosmic harmony under the king's rule. The mirror wall, echoes of other eras. Among the many wonders of Sigiriya, the famous mirror wall holds a special place. Originally, this wall was polished to such perfection that it reflected the image of King Kasapa himself as he walked along its corridors, a literal reflection of his grandeur and dominion over that paradise carved into the rock. However, as the centuries passed, the wall's function evolved. Travelers and pilgrims, moved by reverence and the human desire to leave a trace of their passage, began inscribing messages and thoughts directly onto its surface. These inscriptions, some dating back to the 6th century, form an impressive collection of poetry, amorous reflections, religious tributes, and commentaries on the frescoes of Sigiriya. This practice created a true ancestral visitor's book, offering today a rare glimpse into the inner lives and emotions of ordinary people from antiquity. The inscriptions on the mirror wall recall other traditions of historical graffiti, such as the marks left by ancient visitors on the pyramids of Giza, proving that the need to connect with a place and perpetuate one's own memory is a universal human impulse. Sigiriya as a fortress, natural and planned, defensive architecture. The site of Sigiriya was chosen not only for its stunning beauty, but above all, for its formidable defensibility. Rising about 200 meters above the verdant plains, the rocky massif offered unparalleled military advantages. Beyond the physical difficulty of climbing it, its elevated position provided defenders with a field of vision stretching for dozens of kilometers, allowing them to anticipate any movement of enemy troops. The steep slopes and vertical walls of the rock served as natural barriers against direct attacks, making any conquest attempt extremely difficult without sophisticated siege equipment, which was uncommon in the region at the time. Thus, Casapa not only built a fortress, but chose an almost impregnable stronghold to consolidate his rule. The boulder gardens, nature as an ally in defense. Above the water gardens, visitors encounter the fascinating boulder gardens, a clever integration between the natural landscape and Sigiriya's military design. These gardens consist of massive rock outcrops, a natural formation skillfully incorporated into the fortress's defense plan. The winding paths between enormous stone blocks not only offered scenic beauty, but also served as tactical traps, forcing enemies to advance along narrow, predictable routes. Some rocks were positioned to be easily pushed onto attackers during any invasion attempts. The use of natural elements for defensive purposes recalls, in a way, the use of the rock gardens of Ryoanji in Kyoto, although there the function is contemplative, while in Sigiriya the objective was eminently strategic. Terraced gardens, taming the rock with architecture. As one ascends toward the summit of Sigiriya, the terraced gardens represent the perfect harmony between nature and human intervention. Stairways, corridors, and terraces carefully carved into the very rock guide visitors along a safe path to the top. These terraces also served multiple purposes: cultivation areas, platforms for small structures, and of course, additional defensive elements. The vertically layered construction allowed the fortress to be self-sufficient and resilient, even under siege. This approach to land use directly recalls the ingenuity of the Inca architects at Machu Picchu, where gardens and structures were meticulously integrated into the mountain slopes. In both Sigiriya and Machu Picchu, the adaptation of architecture to the terrain reveals a profound and sophisticated understanding of the environment. The masterful defense of Sigiriya, strategy in every stone. As one walks through the passages of Sigiriya, the visitor is constantly reminded of the defensive ingenuity of its builders. Even before reaching the base of the rock, invaders would have had to face a complex system of moats and massive walls, designed to slow down and confuse enemy forces. The main entrance was deliberately narrow and winding, funneling enemy troops into tight corridors where they could be easily ambushed. At strategic points, enormous stones were positioned to be hurled down upon the aggressors. Stairways were cleverly designed to be removable or destructible in times of emergency, cutting off access and forcing attackers to expose themselves to lethal dangers. This combination of natural and man-made defenses makes Sigiriya one of the most impressive fortresses of antiquity, a perfect synthesis of art, engineering, and military strategy. Royal quarters at the summit of Sigiriya, luxury, power, and strategy. At the very top of the grand rock of Sigiriya were the residential quarters that served as the dwelling place for King Casapa and his court. These structures, built from solid blocks of brick and stone, still preserve visible remnants today, with partial walls that have withstood the wear of time. The scale of these constructions is impressive. The stone blocks, although no exact measurements are recorded, are estimated to weigh several tons each, suggesting a monumental effort in their extraction, transport, and placement. To create flat areas suitable for the construction of palaces and pavilions, it was necessary to massively excavate the irregular rocky surface. This process required the removal of vast quantities of rock and earth, indicating the mobilization of a colossal workforce, possibly involving hundreds of laborers and the aid of domesticated elephants to move the heaviest materials. The ability to mold such an inhospitable space into a functional and luxurious urban center reveals not only material power, but also an impressive sophistication in planning and engineering execution. This monumental architectural achievement at Sigiriya finds a parallel in other historical accomplishments, such as the celebrated Inca citadel of Machu Picchu in Peru. In both cases, we see civilizations that, defying extreme geographic conditions, succeeded in harmoniously integrating monumental architecture into the natural landscape, elevating the concept of environmental adaptation to a level of exceptional art and technique. Sigiriya, majesty, innovation and legacy. The scale and precision involved in the development of Sigiriya highlight its significance as more than a simple military refuge. It was and remains a powerful symbol of authority and deified royalty. Kasapa sought not only physical security, his fortress was a tangible manifestation of his right to the throne, his artistic vision, and his ability to master nature and adversity. Sigiriya was designed to be admired by both his subjects and his adversaries. Its clever defenses, luxurious aristocratic quarters, and lush hanging gardens composed a setting that conveyed the monarch's supremacy in all spheres. Political, military, cultural, and spiritual. Through this integration of art, architecture, and strategy, Sigiriya has established itself as one of the most remarkable achievements of urban engineering in antiquity. Sigiriya, more than ruins, a living testimony of humanity today, Sigiriya stands as a powerful reminder of human ingenuity. A testament to our ancestral ability to shape nature with beauty, function, and purpose. This archaeological site is not merely a reliquary of ancient stones. It is a living narrative, an open window into the life of a civilization that flourished amid adversity, overcoming technical and geographical limits with creativity and resilience. Each excavation, each fragment unearthed, broadens our understanding not only of ancient Sri Lanka, but also of the universal impulses that shape humanity. The desire to create, to protect oneself, and to leave a legacy. Sigiriya exemplifies how, even with the relatively limited resources of the time, ancient societies achieved levels of sophistication in urban planning, engineering, and artistic expression that continue to impress and inspire us today. The future of rediscovery, Sigiriya and beyond. The story of Sigiriya is far from fully uncovered. With each new archaeological campaign, with each in-depth study, new clues emerge about the lives, beliefs, and aspirations of those who once inhabited the site. Ongoing research promises to unveil even more about the intimate details of the society that brought the fortress to life, their technologies, cultural practices, and survival strategies. Sigiriya is not merely a monument lost in time. It is living proof that the history of humanity is far more complex, ingenious, and astonishing than we have been taught. When we gaze upon this colossal fortress, with its hidden gardens, its nearly impossible hydraulic engineering, and its masterfully integrated architecture, we are compelled to admit our ancestors possessed knowledge that we still barely understand today. Each stone, each mural, each hidden garden in Sigiriya echoes a powerful message. The past still holds secrets that challenge our worldview. Secrets that show us that perhaps, just perhaps, the history we know is merely the surface of something much greater and far more fascinating. And if Sigiriya is capable of rewriting what we think we know about ancient civilizations, how many other mysteries are still hidden, waiting to be revealed? Thank you for watching. Now, YouTube is recommending two videos especially for you, and I am sure you will be amazed by them as well. Click and keep exploring more mysteries with us.